This is a story of two men whose dream it is to rediscover the North American continent by canoe. Verlen Kruger and Steve Landick ultimately will travel 28,000 miles by portage and paddle in an extreme test of human endurance, both mental and physical, that has never before been attempted.
If they successfully complete this journey, it will break all previous records for time and distance canoeing. But that's really not the point. Their goal is not to establish new records. Instead, it's to fulfill a dream they've had all their lives, a dream that's become an obsession. What motivated the two of you to undertake this project, a project that a lot of people would probably consider crazy?
Well, for myself, I had read a lot about the early pioneers, the explorers, and the fur traders, and I related with those. And as time went on, I wanted to be or do something like this, and then I discovered the canoe, and then it became canoe-related. And then when Steve and I got together, we both had found that we had the same type of a dream, and we finally decided we was going to go ahead and do it rather than just dreaming about it. And the trip that we came up with kind of evolved. And I think we have kind of would like to both been explorers 200 years ago, but we're too late for that. So we're exploring this continent now in a new way by canoe. It's a whole new world.
No single section of the journey was chosen for ease of travel or to simply increase their overall mileage. On the contrary, this trip is the combined result of many separate and unique adventures that add up to what is certainly the ultimate canoe challenge. The voyage started in early May of last year at Red Rock Lake, high in the Rocky Mountains. From there, through a series of waterways, the Missouri and Illinois rivers, Great Lakes, and several tough portages, they broke into the Bay of Fundy, 5,682 miles later, where they were exposed to the full fury of the North Atlantic in late fall. Next, it's down the eastern seaboard. 2,653 miles away lie the Florida Everglades. When they arrived at Key West at Christmas time, they had already set a new world record for long-distance canoeing, and they were only one-third of the way through their challenge. While traversing the Gulf Coast, they had time to contemplate their next obstacle, that of canoeing up the full length of the mighty Mississippi, a feat never before attempted. By early April, Verlen and Steve paddled through the Quad Cities, 11,000 miles and 1 year since they began.
Your project is different. It's something that hasn't, to my knowledge, been done before. What was the reaction of your family and friends when you first broached this idea, and what do they think today?
I don't think they like the idea too well, but they were very good about it, and became, I would say, our biggest boosters. They understood, that we had to do it and accepted that idea. I don't think they quite understood the idea that we being gone, but they accept the fact that we've got to do it.
Steve, have you ever felt like quitting this whole thing?
Well, I've thought about quitting, but I never seriously considered it. I guess I've just thought what it would be like if I did quit. And I think that that's one thing that's far too overplayed in our society is never to quit. I think it takes a lot more courage and wisdom at times to quit. And I hope that if the time comes and those circumstances arise, that I'll have that to do so. That's why I'm more worried about not being able to quit than I am to quit.
The toughest part of their journey lies ahead, the Canadian wilderness. This is also a turning point of their journey. Can they canoe the 4,000 miles to the Arctic Ocean, turn around and paddle another 3,000 miles back to the northwestern border of the United States, and all before winter sets in? If not, it can prove disastrous. They will be relying heavily on their equipment during this leg of their journey, perhaps more than any other. Because of the physical demands on all their equipment, especially their canoes, the boats used have to be up to the task. After failing to find a canoe that met their specifications, it was good old American ingenuity that helped Verlen with his one-man canoe design. His guidelines were comfort, speed, and durability. And after many attempts, he succeeded in coming up with this extremely strong, durable canoe, weighing only 50 pounds. Its specialized features make it perhaps the best canoe anywhere for upstream travel. What should he name his new boat?
Design has a canoe, but as you can see, it's got features of a kayak. So I guess you could maybe call it a hybrid. It's neither a duck nor a goose. We call it the loon.
If there's one thing in my life that's missing, the time that I spend alone. Sailing on the cool and bright clear water. Lots of those friendly people.
Well, I've had a lot of jobs even before I was in the Navy. And I really feel that out of everything I've done, although it's hard to call it a job, this is what I do best, is to paddle on this canoe here. And I feel that by attempting to complete this trip, that I've given myself the best opportunity that I could ever have to reach for my potential.
Yeah.
And I think that has more significance to me than anything else.
Once they reach San Francisco, 20,000 miles and almost 2 years since they began, they have a mere 8,342 miles left before they reach their final destination. However, traversing the Grand Canyon upstream on the Colorado River has never successfully been done before. If they make it, they will be homeward bound to Lansing, Michigan. On November 1st of 1982, their ultimate canoe challenge will be completed with 28,388 miles of adventure behind them.
You know, here we are out here doing something that most people never get an opportunity to do. I feel very grateful that I've had the privilege of being able to do this, and I feel certain, I guess you say responsibility to share it with those who have dreams but can't do it.